Okay, here we have an example of a linear regression problem. So this one says a pediatrician wanted to estimate a linear function that relates a child's height, h, to their head circumference, c. She randomly selects 9 children from her practice, measures their height and head circumference, and obtains the data shown below. It says let h represent the independent variable and c the dependent variable. Okay, well, if we're doing that, if we're letting H represent the independent variable and C the dependent variable, well, normally we think about independent as X and dependent as Y. So this is what's going to tell us that our height is going to go in our list 1 and our head circumference is going to go in our list 2. Now, part A says use a graphing utility to draw a scatter diagram. Okay, well, let me show you the data points here. So if you need to, you can pause this so that you can write each one of these down. Be very, very careful when you do that. Make sure that you copy everything exactly as it is. If you even have a decimal point off, then it will skew your data completely. Okay, now to save time, I've actually already put in the data into the L1 and the L2 list in my calculator. And here again, once you've put these numbers in, you should always go back and double check them, because if you are just off by a little bit, it will throw your entire thing off. So this is where we're going to make the vast majority of our mistakes here. So make sure you enter those numbers in correctly. Okay, to graph the scatter diagram, we're going to hit second and then y equals for stat plot. We're going to choose enter on number 1, make sure that our on is highlighted, and then we're going to do zoom 9. And here is our scatter diagram. Now, a lot of times they're going to ask you if this by itself is a function. And in this case, this would not be a function because, look, this doesn't pass the vertical line test, does it? Actually, these two data points have the exact same x value. They're both 26.75, but one of them has a y value of 17.3, the other one has a y value of 17.5. So this is not a function to begin with. All right, let's go back to our screen, to our notes here, so that we can see what else they're asking us to do, because we have our scatter diagram on our calculator. Now it says use a graphing utility to find the line of best fit to the data. Express the solution using function notation. Okay, so back to our calculator. Now we want to get our line of best fit, or our linear regression. So we're going to go to stat and then arrow over to calc and choose number 4 for LinReg, linear regression, and hit enter. So here now we have our A value and our B value that goes into our equation. Okay, so I'm going to jot those down. Let's go to 2 decimal places. I'm going to go back to my notes page so that I can write that down. So for part B here, we can rewrite that as y equals, now remember your a value was 0.37 and then our b value was 7.33 if we round to 2 decimal places. Now this said express the solution using function notation. Well, normally we talk about the function in terms of x. Well, we don't have really x in our problem. This is an h instead of an x. So let's write this as better notation. Circumference in terms of height, we're going to write that as c of h equals 0.37. Now remember, instead of x's, we used h's. And then plus 7.33. So this would be a much better representation of function notation. Now we're going to go through and we're going to finish this out in the next video.